Now, B due to solenoid by using Ampere's law. So we know that it is the solenoid and here you have to connect the power source. Now let's consider that I current is passing in this direction. Now you have to imagine an ampere loop. So I conveniently take this PQRS rectangular loop. Now to apply Ampere's law for this ampere loop, I have to take along PQ plus along QR plus along RS plus along SP. This entire sum must be equal to mu naught times of current threaded in the loop. If you observe the magnetic here along PQ, the length element is like this. This is DL and then the magnetic field is in this direction. Now the angle is 90. When the two vectors are perpendicular, their dot product must be equal to 0. So in that case, here this becomes 0 and this SR or RS rather, that is also 0 as theta is equal to 90. So I can put zeros here. Now if an observer is standing here at this particular position and if he observes that for him this is the current direction. So current coming out, suppose if he is looking at this particular loop, if the current is coming out towards him is always equal to current going away from him. Therefore, the magnetic field is getting cancelled. So therefore, this will be 0. The magnetic field here, B, will be 0. So that's the reason why we can cancel out this and we can put this also 0. Now what is left out along QR? If you observe this QR, L is also in the same direction, B also in the same direction. Therefore, this angle would be 0. Therefore, and BDL cos 0, integral over DL is nothing but L, should be equal to mu naught. Here, the current through one loop is I, but if the total number of loops is N, then this will be equal to mu naught times of Ni. Or the B, the value of magnetic field inside the solenoid is equal to B is equal to mu naught N by L times of I. If you represent the number of turns per unit length as small n, then we get mu naught Ni. So finally, the answer is B, inside the solenoid, mu naught times of Ni, where I is the current passing through it, and then N is the number of turns per unit length. Outside the solenoid, the magnetic field is zero. And here, perpendicular direction also, the magnetic field is zero. So this is the second application. We try to visualize the Ampere loop here. Now let's consider that this is the solenoid. Actually, let's consider that this solenoid is very long and you are taking the loop like this. So this is making 90 and this also making 90 with magnetic field, and through this it's cancelled because the net current coming out is zero. Therefore only along the line which is passing through the solenoid, the B and DL are in the same direction. Therefore BL must be equal to mu naught times of Ni, capital N here, the total number of turns. Now if you shift this L to that side, number of turns per unit length, we represent it with a small n. So B dot Ni is the formula for this long straight solenoid. I'll show in my demonstration that the magnetic field is restricted to inside only. Of course, if the solenoid is small, there is some magnetic field existing even outside also. But if you consider a very big solenoid and the turns are very tightly wound, then the magnetic field is restricted to inside the solenoid only. That we will see just in the demonstration.